video, we actually started with the lesson life processes, and we started with nutrition, and we finished with autotrophic nutrition. Now, according to the state government, nutrition and respiration, both the life process has been skipped. It's not there for you for this academic year. So we are left with only two more. We are left with two more life processes, that is excretion and transportation. So we don't have to. You don't have to learn nutrition and respiration. So we know that under life process there are four life processes are there. We were supposed to learn the four life processes. Which are the four life processes? The four life processes are nutrition, respiration, transportation, and excretion. These are the four life processes. So we know very well there are four life processes, that is nutrition, respiration, transportation, and excretion. Now, according to the government, these two are skipped. These two life processes are skipped. You don't have to study about nutrition and respiration. We have to now focus on transportation and excretion. So today we'll start with transportation. In this video, let us begin with transportation process. Let's begin with the transportation system or transportation. What is transportation? So I have given here the definition for transportation. It's the movement of materials. It's the movement of materials from one part to another part. What does transportation process does? What it does is it will help in moving the material from one part to another, from one region to another, usually from the region of their availability to the region of their use, storage, and elimination. Try to understand this definition. Is a movement of materials from one part to another, usually from the region of their availability. For example, we know very well food. Food is digested in the small intestine. Then from the small intestine, the small intestine becomes the place of availability, where it is available. From there, and it is sent to different part, to the region of their use and storage and elimination. That's what transportation does. It's the movement of material from one part to another, from one region to another, usually from the region of their availability to the region of their use, storage, and elimination. So transportation is seen in all the organism, all the different types of organism, we see transportation. Today, we are going to, in this lesson, we are going to learn about transportation in human being. In case of human being, the transportation system is also called circulatory system. It is also called circulatory system. The circulatory system consists of tubes, nothing but the blood vessels, a pumping heart, and the circulatory fluids. So we have two kinds of fluids, that is blood and lymph. If the fluid, the circulatory fluid is blood, then it will form the blood vascular system. If the circulatory fluid is lymph, then it forms the lymphatic system. So this is what we have. This is the introduction for your transportation in human beings. Okay. Now let us learn about what is blood, what is the function of blood, and the blood vessel and its types. Okay. Let's learn about blood. What is blood? And what are the functions of blood? And what is blood made up of or composed of? Okay. So what is blood? We all know blood is a fluid connective tissue. It is a fluid connective tissue. It's a connective tissue.
tube
because it connects various organs in our body. It flows throughout our body. It flows. It is a mobile liquid, right? It is a mobile fluid. Okay, it's a fluid connective tissue. It's not stationary. It is a mobile fluid. Mobile means to move around. Mobile fluid connective tissue. And we know blood is red in color. It is reddish in color. What gives the color to the blood? It is reddish in color. What is responsible for the color of our blood? We know very well. It is the hemoglobin. What is hemoglobin? Hemoglobin is the red pigment present in our blood, which is responsible for the color of the blood. So hemoglobin is the red pigment. Okay, so that is why our blood is red in color. Then the blood which carries the oxygen, the oxygen will be attached to the hemoglobin. We call that blood as oxygenated blood. What is oxygenated blood? Blood which is carrying oxygen attached to hemoglobin. Attached to hemoglobin. This term you should remember. Okay, we'll be using this term while we learn the functioning, how heart function. Okay, what is oxygenated blood? The blood which is carrying oxygen, which is attached to the hemoglobin. Then, what is deoxygenated blood? Deoxygenated blood is the blood which is carrying carbon dioxide. Deoxygenated blood is the blood which is carrying carbon dioxide. Okay, so that is deoxygenated blood. Then what are the components of the blood? What are the components of the blood? So we have, the blood has two components. One is the plasma, other one is the cells in the blood. So components of blood. Components of blood. Okay, so which are the different components of the blood? The components of blood are plasma and blood corpuscles. Okay, the blood has two components. One is plasma, other one is blood corpuscles. So let us see what is plasma. Plasma is the fluid matrix. So we know that all the tissue will have a matrix. Sometimes it will be hard, sometimes it will be loose. Here the matrix is fluid. So it's a fluid matrix which is pale yellow in color. Pale yellow in color, and it contains several proteins. It contains several proteins. And on this plasma only, the blood corpuscles, the solid part or the solid part or the solid components of the cells will be, solid components of the blood will be floating. So blood corpuscles are three. They are RBC, WBC and platelets. Okay. So what is RBC? Red blood corpuscles. WBC, white blood corpuscles, and the platelets. And we know very well the function of RBC, WBC, and platelets. RBC will help in absorption of oxygen, and also it will help in absorption of carbon dioxide, and which will help in expelling carbon dioxide. So RBC will help in absorption and transportation of the respiratory gases, and WBC we know very well it will help in fighting against the disease-causing germs. Okay, and platelets will help in clotting of blood. Whenever we get a wound, it will start bleeding. After some time, it will stop. How we stop? It is the platelets which will help. Not only that, even when the capillaries or the veins, they will rupture or due to some pressure, when you fall, when you get a cut, even immediately the platelets will go and seal itself. It will plug the broken part. Thereby, it will prevent the loss of blood, that hemorrhage. Okay, understood? So these are the three different types of blood cells, blood corpuscles. Okay, and we learned the function. Next, we'll be learning about the blood vessels. Okay, thank you. Let us learn about blood vessels. What are blood vessels? Blood vessels are the tubes or pipeline structure through which the blood flows. Okay, they are made up of smooth elastic muscles, because you know the blood has to be pumped through the vessels, and the vessels will contract and relax, and they push the blood forward. That's why it is made up of smooth elastic muscle. Okay, so blood vessels are the tubes or the pipeline structure through which the blood flows. The blood vessels are of three types. They are arteries, veins, and capillaries. So we have three different types of blood vessels, that is arteries, veins, capillaries. So let us see the differences between these two blood vessels, that is arteries and veins. So arteries, always remember, it carries the blood from the heart to different parts of our body. From the heart, it carries the blood to various parts of our body. It does not have valve. It do not have valve. And the flow of blood through the artery is always under pressure. It is always under pressure. And arteries are deep seated. Deep seated means they are located deep. Okay. So that's about arteries. Not only that, the arteries have thick muscles. They are made up, they are thick. Arteries are thick and elastic. Arteries are made up of thick muscle, and here the artery veins are thin and elastic. Okay, so coming to veins, veins always carry the blood from various parts of the body to the heart. That is a function of veins, and it has valves, and the blood flows with little pressure. Little means almost no pressure compared to the flow of blood in arteries. In arteries, it is with pressure. Under pressure, it flows, whereas in veins, it is almost nil. That's why it is with little pressure, and they are located superficially. Whenever you cut your finger while handling anything like a blade or something, you get a cut, right? So what actually gets cut is vein, because it is located superficially, and they are thin and elastic. So these are the two differences between arteries and veins. So now let us learn about capillaries. So what are capillaries? Capillaries are the minute blood vessels. They are so tiny that we cannot see with our naked eyes. That is, we can see arteries and veins. You know very well, this blood vessel is an artery, and you can see the tiny blood vessel, that is the vein. the blood vessel which is not visible to our naked eyes are the capillaries. Capillaries are the minute blood vessels. Minute blood vessels, they are microscopic. They are microscopic. There are only one cell thickness. So now you can tell. So they are microscopic. Cell we cannot see. So here they are of one cell thickness. They are minute blood vessel. So what is the function of capillaries? So what is the function of capillaries? It will help in exchange of materials. Exchange of materials between the blood and the cell. Okay, so they help in exchange of materials. So we should remember, materials means here the nutrients, respiratory gases, water, minerals, or even the waste products. So exchange of materials between the blood and cells, that is the capillaries. Okay, so we have three different types of blood vessels. They are arteries, veins, and capillaries. Now you understood the differences between and the function of arteries, veins, and capillaries. Artery, the function is to carry the blood away from the heart to various parts. Vein, the function is to bring the blood from various parts of the body to the heart. Whereas the capillaries will help in exchange of materials between the blood and the cells. Okay, so these are the functions of arteries, veins, and capillaries. Or the what we learn now is what are blood vessels, their types, and function. In the next video, we'll be learning about heart, the structure of heart, and the functioning of the heart.